following WTVJ special.
It was 1949, and WTVJ was turning South Florida on to television for the very first time.
Good evening, this is Ralph Rennick. Here in this building, Florida television began.
Opening the window to a world of change that would unfold before your very eyes.
Houston, Tranquility Base here. The Eagle has landed.
For nearly half a century, we've shared with you that window, and it's a tradition we'll continue to share for decades to come.
Friends, it is going to happen now for Dade County.
But as you think about where you're going, it's nice to know where you've been. May the good news be yours, celebrating 46 years of WTVJ.
Good evening and welcome. I'm Tony Segreto.
And I'm Jennifer Valoppi here with Bryan Norcross.
Over the next half hour, we'll be peering into our past.
For almost half a century, WTVJ has been your window to South Florida's world.
You've watched as we've emerged from a tourist town hugging the coast into an international community that stretches to the Everglades.
Join us now for a stroll down memory lane as we take you back to our roots.
It was an evening to remember, although fewer than 2,000 people actually saw WTVJ's first broadcast. In those early days, some cars were actually cheaper than televisions. A set cost $299, and you had to finish building it yourself.
And most sat in store windows like this one. You know, in the early 1950s, this downtown Miami Jefferson store was one of the most popular places in town. But you had to get here early just to get a good spot.
Back then, only a handful of shows aired each day. Most of the time, the show to watch was Test Pattern. And believe me, people actually gazed at it for hours.
And you'd sit there looking at it like it was something that had just been invented, waiting for the station to go on the air.
As television's popularity grew, so did the amount of WTVJ programming. There were puppet shows, cooking shows, and dancing shows. But a real community connection was starting to evolve. Sunday morning church services were broadcast from a different church each week. The Kefauver Senate organized crime hearings were shown daily until the politicians left town.
The Gulf Stream is derailed at West
Palm. A skinny kid named Ralph Rennick started reading the news each night, and people were actually tuning in.
He was definitely a very active man, highly respected. He was one of the pioneers of television here.
WTVJ was making history while reporting history as it happened, and South Floridians just couldn't get enough. As the viewing audience grew, so did the number of problems plaguing our community. And over the years, WTVJ coverage actually helped bring solutions. Bumper-to-bumper traffic started to ease with the construction of new highways, built in response to news stories citing the problems. Gambling was coming to an end as police used WTVJ cameras to help catch bookmakers and undercover stings.
We were a force in the community. We were important. People came to us. They depended on us.
The commitment became crystal clear in 1957 when Rennick delivered the first daily television editorial. Until then, editorials were in the newspaper. Ralph Rennick gave them an authoritative voice.
No endorsement would be given any candidate for political office.
There were so many broadcasts first, coverage of raging hurricanes, sporting events of all kinds, lawmaking in action from Tallahassee. From Orange Bowl parades and football games to beauty pageants, there were no rules to break.
We were inventing the medium. I mean, no one said you don't do that, so we just tried everything and did everything.
It was a time of segregation and open racial prejudice. But to help break the pattern, WTVJ aired KKK meetings so people could see how their neighbors were acting behind closed doors.
Sometimes it was more than we could bear, but having it recorded, having it taped, helped the community to better understand what was going on.
There were countless awards, numerous honors. By the time the 60s rolled around, WTVJ was hailed as the best in the business. But no trophy could replace the gift that Skipper Chuck's Popeye Playhouse gave to thousands of new South Florida residents. It came from the Word of the Day game.
Something that we didn't even imagine was happening was that this great influx of Cubans who could not speak English were sitting there learning English from the Skipper Chuck show.
Jennifer, you know Popeye Playhouse, which I was on as a very young child.
Really?
Yeah.
I would pay for this
with Skipper
tape.
Chuck and Scrubby and everybody. It was the very first show in America that was racially integrated.
Well, it was actually 1958, and WTVJ took a very big risk. The show's sponsor, Royal Castle, actually pulled out, And then a little-known restaurant by the name of Burger King stepped in. You know, there is so much history in this place. If only the walls could talk. WTVJ was the Lone Ranger in bringing South Florida viewers this brand new form of home entertainment when the station signed on back in 1949.
What do you think of television?
Oh, I think it's wonderful. You know, I hardly ever watch radio anymore.
The network sent down only a handful of national shows to our small viewing audience, so local programming of all kinds filled those empty hours.
We welcome you to our little get-together.
From Alec Gibson's popular variety show to Lee Dickens' Daredevil stunt program to Jackie Pierce's home shopping guide, WTVJ was experimenting, and you were the guinea pigs.
They became like part of our family, and I sort of felt a kindredship with Jackie Pierce and Alec Gibson.
WTVJ took advantage of that, and by the end of that first year, programming had tripled. TV was quickly replacing radio as South Florida's favorite form of nightly entertainment. Over the years, you were overwhelmed by the different kinds of shows we brought into your homes. Dramas, quiz shows, first-rate movies. But it was the laughter that was keeping you tuned in. TV was here to stay, and it didn't take long for WTVJ to realize the importance of connecting with the viewers of tomorrow.
Children's programming was as necessary and had the same priority as anything else, if not more so, than anything live on television.
For 23 years, 70,000 South Florida children appeared on Popeye Playhouse with Skipper Chuck and Scrubby and the Gang. It was all produced right here in Studio B. If it was something you wanted to see, you saw it only on WTVJ.
Ladies and gentlemen, the Beatles!
The Cleavers, the Bunkers, the Waltons, the Ricardos, the families we all grew up with. We lived, we laughed, and we learned.
Those were the days.
From the hits of yesterday to the ratings rulers of today, WTVJ has always brought the best of entertainment to you, the viewers of South Florida. And it's a tradition we will continue right into the 21st century, barring any real emergency. So do you remember all those shows?
Most of them.
Yeah?
Really, yeah, most of them. But it's news and sports events that jog my memory the most. Bryan Norcross takes a look back.
It was an itsy-bitsy, teeny-weeny, yellow polka dot bikini.
Beautiful girls from all over the universe gathered here in the sun and fun capital of the world. WTVJ brought the Miss Universe pageant to homes all across America for the very first time.
Where the boys are.
Fort Lauderdale is where the boys are. As film crews converge on Broward's beautiful beaches to shoot that Paula Prentice, Connie Francis blockbuster hit. The Museum of Science opens its doors for the very first time, while thrill seekers flock to the Dade County Youth Fair for the second year in a row. And WTVJ introduces News en Español with Manolo Reyes. It's the first Spanish language newscast ever to air in South Florida, developed to help our new Cuban neighbors feel right at home.
Do you remember when? Was it 1959, 1960, or 1961? The answer to this WTVJ trivia question when we come back. May the good news be yours. We're celebrating 46 years of WTVJ. We hope to stay with us. Welcome back. Do you remember when? South Florida hosts its first Miss Universe pageant. The original Where the Boys Are is filmed in Fort Lauderdale, and News en Español makes its debut. If you guessed 1960, you got it. More WTVJ trivia to come. Jennifer?
Well, Brian, as you know, South Florida is such an incredible place for news, and WTVJ's commitment to you, the viewer, has never wavered. The news was a lot different back then, however. Our community was, too.
In the beginning, this was a lab. It was Ralph Renick's news laboratory.
Well, what TVJ stood for, and has always stood for, is integrity.
Everything turn, turn, turn. There is a season, turn, turn, turn. And there's time to every purpose under heaven.
Oh my God.
to be born, a time to die, a time to plant, a time to reap, a time to kill, a time to heal, a time to laugh, a time to weep.
It sounds improbable that such a thing could happen to our president of the United States.
So you may shoot me with your words, you may cut me with your eyes, and I'll rise, I'll rise, I'll rise, out of the shacks of history's shame, or from a past red and pain, I'll rise, I'll rise, I'll rise.
County worker is killed by an automobile.
Things that made news in 1957 wouldn't make news today.
WTVJ News has always stood for excellence, so has WTVJ Sports. In fact, in the early 50s, we produced more sports film than any other station in America. And the man who made us number one, Bernie Rosen, is still here. In 1949, there were no Dolphins, no Heat, no Marlins or Panthers, but always there was WTVJ Sports.
I can't even tell you how many times we covered marble tournaments.
They were like sort of like hometown, and they covered all the sports.
The feature race at Hialeah was featured two afternoons a week. High live, boxing, and wrestling from the Gables Coliseum were shown at night. But University of Miami football and the minor league Miami Marlins got most of the attention. By the time the 60s rolled around, big-time sports and their champions were converging on Miami.
You tell everybody about this fight. And if you want to lose your money, then bet on Sonny.
The Dolphins arrived in 1967, and so did Jane Chastain. WTVJ hired America's first female sportscaster, despite the obstacles.
She'd go out to do an interview with George Wilson, who was the head coach, the first head coach in the Miami Dolphins, and he refused to give her an interview because she was a woman.
Miami has the Dolphins, the greatest football team.
By 1972, the Dolphins were undefeated. They were perfect. And I was honored to be part of the winning WTVJ sports team.
In my 33 years here, I think they sort of set the goal. And then the other stations, I think they made the other stations better.
As the years passed, it was TVJ style that was being emulated across the United States and still is. We created the Extended Weekend Sports Report. And over the past decade, Sports Final has expanded by leaps and bounds. But then again, so has the South Florida sports scene. Jennifer, I never thought in my wildest dreams that we'd ever have four professional sports teams here, and it happened so fast.
Yeah, and it's really made this town major league. Tony, when we come back, how we help you survive the biggest story ever to hit South Florida.
And everything you always wanted to know about Weaver the Weatherman, but were afraid to ask. That's coming up.
They said it wouldn't happen here again. It hadn't for many years. But here at WTVJ, we knew well that this is hurricane country. After all, we've been covering them for almost half a century.
Friends, it is going to happen now for Dade County.
August 24th, 1992. Hurricane Andrew rips through South Florida, and WTVJ is the station you turn to for responsible, accurate hurricane information. That reputation began 42 years earlier when WTVJ covered another small but intense hurricane called King.
This is a very dangerous hurricane, packing winds of about 150 miles an hour.
The 60s began with a huge hurricane called Donna that covered all of South Florida and wrecked the Middle Keys. Cleo, in 1964, went right up US 1. When 1965 brought Hurricane Betsy, WTVJ brought you coverage in two languages. And in 1979, Hurricane David just skimmed us before going in at Jupiter.
It was a false alarm, but you were ready because we told you to be. Throughout the years, WTVJ has brought you hurricane coverage you can count on. And one more thing is certain. The more things change, the more they stay the same. Hurricane Andrew wasn't the big one, but it showed us we can survive anything if we work together.
A rainbow shining over us.
As sure as the rain falls here just about every summer afternoon, Bob Weaver is here to tell us about it.
Almost everyone in South Florida knows Weaver the weatherman, but not many people know too much about him. Doesn't hurt to ask.
Well, nothing much has changed since I started here at WTVJ about years ago. All right, put on a few pounds, but my color's better.
I love television. I love everything about it because I'm really an audience. I'm part of the audience, and I know what I like, and it seems to transfer to what the audience likes.
The boat's coming to take us back to the studio, and we'll see you later.
Rain or sunny, the dolphins will emerge number one-y.
Hey, Bob, where did you get that bird? That weepy bird.
Remember the bird that had a little spring on its neck and you could buy it in the store? We put it on one day, and then we'd do the forecast. And then after that, I would come on and do the regular program. And that lasted years and years. And then we took it off, and people were complaining, oh, they wanted to see the bird.
Bob, how'd you learn how to write backwards?
Somebody came up with this brilliant idea, and it really worked and became such a big hit. People talked about it everywhere, wondering how you did all that backwards. But actually, most of it was a, you know, mirror.
Bob, what is your most memorable moment with Ralph Rennick?
One time he tossed it to me, and I was by the board there, and he said, we don't have a lot of time. Here's Bob. I said, thanks, Ralph. Now back to you.
Bob, are you really the longest reigning weatherman on TV?
That's why. See, if you're a weatherman, you have to rain.
You know, Jen, there was only one problem with Weaver's writing backwards trick in the early days. His pocket was always on the wrong side.
That could be a problem. Yeah. But, Tony, Jackie Gleason actually solved that problem for him. Once Gleason came here for a station promotion, and he told Weavy to move his pocket.
Right.
So he did, and that confused people even more.
It confused Weavy, too. Very interesting. But just like the question Bryan Norcross wants to ask you, Brian?
Do you remember when? How good is your memory when it comes to South Florida trivia? It was a year that ended in turmoil, one that began with a very bizarre twist. How apropos that Abracadabra is the song of the year, as thousands flock to this sea grape tree in Miami, hoping to rub some of its so-called magical healing sap into their ailing bodies. The tree on Southwest 4th Street caused such an uproar it had to be removed and was eventually sold in pieces. Former Dolphin great Mercury Morris is found guilty of trafficking in cocaine. And Epcot Center opens in Orlando. Supposed Sheikh Mohammed Al-Fassi flees after spending millions of dollars he doesn't have to support his decadent lifestyle. He leaves behind hundreds of creditors and a half-built shrine that was to have been his home. But he will be back. And we're thinking pink as the artist Christo wraps the islands of Biscayne Bay in plastic. So do you remember when? Was it 1980, 1981, or 1982? The answer and some things that never made it on the air, coming right up. Stay tuned as we celebrate 46 years of WTVJ. Can you guess when these events came into your living room? It's the year Mercury Morris goes from football star to convicted drug dealer. Mohammed Al-Fassi goes from a welcome guest to a wanted man. And Epcot makes its Central Florida debut. The year was 1982. Did you get it, Tony?
I sure did. In fact, who could forget 1982?
Yeah, I was at Epcot that year.
So was I.
Really?
Yeah.
That was quite a trip,
really cool,
I'll tell you.
Yeah.
Well, you know, Tony, and this doesn't mean you, but we all do make mistakes in this business, and a lot have certainly been made here over the past 46 years.
You don't see most of them. In fact, most of them get left on the edit room floor.
We hope.
Until now.
The Dolphins make a surprising trade. Who was it, Roger?
I'm Tony.
Every Halloween preacher that you can imagine has paraded through here.
Highway planners say it's going to get a lot worse in the years to come.
God damn.
Jim?
Bob.
Bob?
It's almost automatic.
Good evening from the Channel 4 newsroom. Former Governor Reuben Askew is in Miami tonight following his formal announcement.
What are you doing back there?
Good evening, I'm on Ask We.
And I'm the brand new Jim Brosmer.
Are we on?
Three, two,
my mother, hello.
Yes.
Three,
hello.
Two, one.
I hope you're doing
well. That's how we remember who we are.
Hey, good. Next week we get you a watch.
Most unwelcome of all, and just stay and do that.
Congratulations, guys. You are the best. Number one. Nobody can touch him.
Thank you for joining us. Back tonight at 11.
We hope you've enjoyed our look back, and now it's time to look ahead.
For the past few months, the eyes of the world have been upon us, and we've made quite an impression.
From the Super Summit to the Super Bowl with Pavarotti in between, South Florida has a lot to be proud of.
So we're going to leave you now with a special birthday greeting written 30 years ago by longtime WTVJ viewer Ann Davidson.
It was her gift to us, and we'd like to share it with you.
Good night.
And may the good news be yours.
Stay tuned to WTVJ from early morning. Stay tuned to WTVJ to late at night. Did you all know that Channel 4 goes on at dawning? With news and weather and sports and songs to your delight. Oh, Messrs. Rennick, Weaver, Frank, and Jim Vigendi. What would we ever do without Couture McGraw? We're here to celebrate with birthday cake and candy. Happy anniversary to Channel 4.